Hello, I'm Reverend Sam, and I'm your host on Power Encounter TV broadcast. I pray that the dews of heaven will locate you. I pray that heaven's goodness will smile on you this day. I pray that God will cause his glory to appear, and your shame will disappear. In the name of Jesus, light shine, I command. Let there be light, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Wow, welcome to Power Encounter once again. I want us to go to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3 today. And I'll read from verse 1 to verse 3. I really want to point out one fact today. Are you a spiritual Christian or are you a carnal Christian? Now, there are two sets of believers, the baby and the mature. Those babies are called carnal Christian because they still manifest carnality, works of the flesh, things that do not show to the unbelievers or the outside world that something has happened within them. They are truly born again, but God is not yet being seen in their outward life. Those are the people that are called babies or carnal Christians. And there are those who are called spiritual or mature Christians. But the unfortunate thing is that we have over 80% of the people in the church of God operating under the category of carnal believers. Because we don't exercise ourselves in the word of God. We don't put the word of God to use. You know that just like I am right now, if I want my muscles, if I want to put on more muscles, I don't need to go for surgery. All I need to do is to begin to exercise the muscles I have. And in a few weeks or few months, you see that my muscles start coming out. And all of you start saying, Reverend has started building up his body. But the truth is, it is the same muscles, but being built by exercise. It's the same thing in the spirit realm. Your spiritual muscle can be built when you continue to practice the word of God every day. And as you practice God's word, you will be maturing more and more and more and more. And this is where God has problem with many of us, because we are not ready to go through the rigor of exercise. I'm sure you know that physical exercise entails a lot of pain and inconvenience. And the truth is, an average person does not want to be inconvenienced. An average person does not want pain. And that's why we remain the way we are. Just in the same way, in the physical realm, if I want my muscles to grow, I have to endure the pain so that I can have the desired result. In the same way, in the spirit realm, if you want to become a mature believer, you have to be ready to endure the pain. You must be ready to endure whatever the Bible says endure. When I use the word endure, most of the time, to obey the word of God is not easy. To obey the word of God is like endurance. Let's go and read from verse 1 to verse 3 of 1 Corinthians chapter 3, and then you will see certain category of people that Apostle Paul was talking about. He said, "And I, brethren, could not speak to you as unto spiritual, but as unto carnal, even as unto babies in Christ. I have fed you with milk and not with meat." You see, those are different categories of teaching. Some people, if you start teaching on spiritual sacrifices, fasting and prayer, loving your enemy, praying in tongues, you know, they feel uncomfortable. But when you talk about God will bless you, you will break through, your enemy will die, they flex their muscle and they are happy. Listen, that shows that your level of, you're a child of God, yeah, but it shows your level of spiritual maturity is low. If all you desire is for your enemies to die, your spiritual maturity level is low. Do you remember James and John? When Jesus went to a particular territory and the people there did not want to accept him, James and John said, "Master, let us call that fire from heaven. Let it consume all of them." Jesus said, "No. You don't even understand the kind of spirit that you have." In other words, you don't have the spirit to kill people. You have the spirit to save them. For God does not have joy over the death of a sinner, but for them to repent and be saved. Now, Apostle Paul said, "I fed you with milk and not with meat." That's why you need to embrace my ministry. I have the grace of God to teach you in the word of God so that you can begin to grow spiritually. You know, I have this telecast program come up on the air 3 days in a week, 6 times, morning and evening, Tuesday, 7:30 in the morning, 11 p.m., and on Thursday, 7:30 in the morning, 11 p.m., and on Friday, 7:30 in the morning and 11 p.m., and I have Secret of Glory and Power on Monday at 8 o'clock at night. Make sure you connect so that you can begin to get blessed and begin to mature in the Word of God. Apostle Paul said, "For hitherto you are not able to bear it, neither yet are you now able, for you are yet carnal. For we are asked, there is among you envy and strife and divisions. Are you not carnal and walk as ordinary men?" You see that? When you envy other people, you abuse each other, No. All those things are a sign of carnality. And God cannot be glorified when you are living a carnal life. You need to start developing yourself. Start disciplining yourself. Love your enemies. Pray for those who persecute you. Your husband is not doing good, but love him. Your children are not doing right, but love them. Do everything that the Bible says you should do. The Bible says the anger of man does not fulfill the righteousness of God. So stop getting angry with people. As you begin to apply those things, your spiritual muscle will begin to develop. Your spiritual muscle will begin to develop. And as you begin to develop spiritually, it will be easier for the revelation and the sweetness of the Word of God to begin to be found in your mortal body. I want to pray with you, but I want you to watch this testimony first. This particular woman, I was in a program in somewhere in Lagos at a particular time, and she had pains on her chest. She was brought to the program. She had pains on her chest, and she said to me that the pain would have been there for 3 years. I said, "I don't understand." She said she feels the pain every day for 3 years, and God took that pain away. Watch that program. Watch the video, and I'll be back to pray with you. God bless you real good.
Right now that I'm talking to you now, what's wrong with your body?
I just want to chest something.
Sorry?
My chest.
Your chest is failing you?
Yes.
How long has it been?
3 years.
No, I mean, how long have you been having that chest pain?
3 years.
3 years?
Yes, sir.
You've been having the chest pain for 3 years?
Also, that causes this pain, I command you from spirit, out!
Amen.
Out of her.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Check it.
Glory, feel everything.
Do like this. Like this.
Right. Welcome back. It's time to pray now. Place your hand wherever you are sick. Lord, I thank you for the anointing to heal the sick. I thank you because I believe you give me this anointing for the healing of nations. Therefore, I pray that in the name of Jesus, everyone that is afflicted from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet, receive healing, receive deliverance. In the name of Jesus, I pray for you, whatever the enemy has put in your life as a cross that you are bearing, as a yoke that has refused to give way, in the mighty name of Jesus, I command them to give way now. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Now, there's a special program that God has asked me to start organizing now. It's called All Believers Conference. It's a conference program where everyone that is a child of God, regardless of church, we are all welcome to be there. It's not a church program. It's my ministry program. And that program is going to come up on the 8th of June, 2018. Now, the 8th of June is a Friday. I want you to mark it in your calendar. Friday, 8th of June by 7 p.m. The theme of the program is overcoming satanic opposition to your glory. We all have glory, but we know that a lot of us have a lot of opposition. If it's not against you, it might be against your children. It might be against your wife or your husband. Listen, I want you to bring them to that program that day. Mark it in your calendar and make sure you are there. God of heaven will minister to you. And we are going to pray together. I will teach the word and we will pray together against the oppositions that are present against your glory. And after that, those who are sick, afflicted, on these special ministrations, I will minister to them, and I believe God will take care of those problems. The program is going to take place at Divine Heritage Hall. It's at 9755 South Kirkwood Road, Houston, Texas, 77099. The venue again is Divine Heritage Church, 9755 South Kirkwood Road, Houston, Texas, 77099. As you come, you will experience God, because I know there is nothing that my God cannot do. I'm going to go right now because Time is not always on my side. But I know that God has started a miracle in your life. And as we meet together at that program, I believe that God has started that miracle, He will finish it. And if you have been healed and you felt the power of God, come to that program. Come and testify. And I know God will do more for you as you come. Until I come here again next time, don't you ever forget that no matter what you have gone through in life, now that you're a child of God, one thing is very sure, that your testimony will be that you are wonderful because Jesus is real. I see you next time. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Lord, you are great. Thunder announce your presence. The storm announce your power. I can't imagine your greatness. Yeah, yeah. Heaven and earth adore you. Angels bow before you. What a mighty God we serve. There's nobody but you.